falling into foreclosure.
Politicians and government agencies lined up today to help a North Minneapolis woman save her home. And she won. She won at least some more time to settle her case with her lenders. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Mark Saxenmeyer has the details now. Mark?
Lee and Bill, fresh off their successful effort last Monday to save a South Minneapolis man's home, the group Occupy Homes Minnesota now has city council members, state legislators, and even the attorney general joining forces with them. They say they'll fight the banks one house at a time until they can effect widespread change.
Outside Mayor R.T. Rybeck's office, a colorful sign asking for the mayor to sign a petition in support of one of his constituents to help save her home.
What happened to her is what happened to a lot of Americans. The economy tanked.
The mayor hasn't signed, but 7 city council members have, including Gary Schiff.
What we need is for the bank to come back to the table.
Just one woman with 2 sons and 2 part-time jobs trying to keep her home by renegotiating her mortgage, reducing it just a few $100 a month.
I'm not asking for a handout. I'm just asking them to give me time and meet me halfway.
Today, a judge did just that. She's been given a reprieve until Friday because some big guns have stepped up to bat for her.
Attorney General Lori Swanson wants to investigate potential mortgage fraud in this case.
To make sure that there was no wrongdoing, no illegal activity.
Thank you.
5 Eyewitness News has profiled Monique's case several times, prompting email after email from others in the Twin Cities who have shared similar struggles to keep their homes.
You know, I think it's a one-by-one situation right now, but what I hope comes across loud and clear is that the city of Minneapolis sends a message to the banks. We don't need any more vacant homes.
There's too much history there. I've raised my kids there.
What's up?
I will do what I need to do in order to keep my house.
Those fighting to save Monique's home, including Congressman Keith Ellison and State Rep Bobby Joe Champion, now have, as I said, until Friday to plot their legal strategy. That's when Monique's case will go back to court, this time to trial in front of a jury of her peers. Reporting live, Mark Saxenmeyer, 5 Eyewitness News.